is Faith Nkuka reporting from Mass Communication TV, and we are here at the auditorium where the 20th anniversary of Ibinedio University Okada is taking place. Wow, it's going to be a lot of fun and exciting. Stay tuned while we take you inside the hall.
It's your end, and the list is so long. You might have to get a whole booklet to read through, because the more you're reading, the more names you see of the juggernauts. These are men and women who have made their mark in different aspects. Ladies and gentlemen, your hands please together again. Not just opening a university for the sake of it, but returning back to where it should be. Uninterrupted education from September to June. That is the way to go to the world. And that's what the man has kept faith with the last 20 years. So I think this man should be celebrated. And I'm happy that the world is celebrating him. One good thing about it is that in such
yeah.
curiosity.
What are they need? a woman of substance, in beauty and in grace, integrity and dexterity. Let me tell you, we welcome you. We are aware that you have provided emotional stability and have contributed to the good health of our family. Thank you and God bless you. And indeed, this woman we are talking about, God not only gave him life, he gave me courage and the ability to navigate all daunting complexities and uncertainties. And what we are seeing today is the fruit of a selfless, benevolent, generous man of God. Sir, you have provided limitless possibilities and opportunities. And may God continue to bless you. Amen. Did you hear me? Thank you. Being Nigeria's premier private university with certificate number 001 is an astonishing achievement and transformational. The institution's innovation and credibility represents what Millennium University stands for. Since the last 20 years, the existence of this university has remained absolutely path-breaking and exemplary. The university now has 7 colleges with 29 departments, all are fully accredited with the National Commission, University Commissions, and all relevant professional courses are accredited in this university. I said all, and all means all the programs of the university are accredited academically and professionally. Since 1999, Millennium University has continued to champion educational revolution in higher education in Nigeria, changing the narrative in higher education pedagogy, remaining very relevant as a private university but with public interest and cosmopolitan in its impartation in the society. Our modest achievement over the years is volume. Our university has continued to be the nation's treasure, providing the energy and the engine for social mobility, postulating solutions to critical societal problems such as unemployment and unemployability. This 20th Founders Day celebration is not just auspicious. I dare say that is an appropriate time to reflect on the vision, the mission, the objectives that have established the university. Today, our Smart Campus program are fully accredited, and we have established in the first university in Nigeria 4 ICT academies, which is a testimony of our determination to ride in the waves of globalization and technological change. Need I say that our new centers of excellence allows the university to expand our research domain and the frontiers of expertise. The documentary of our Blue Sky Graduates revealed that the capacity of our university to produce top-class leaders and intellectual giants is not far-fetched. After watching the documentary, which will be played today, of our Blue Sky Graduates, if you are in doubt, that doubt will vanish. Our determination to always produce future-ready generation of leaders remains resolute with a view to completely dominating the world of ideas. Your Excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, we are all here today because God made a way and permitted it. This is also the opportunity to bring in mind the role of members of staff who pioneer and render meritorious service to this university since inception for the last 20 years. 12 of them will be honored today with the Distinguished Pioneering Service Award. Please, if the 12 of you are here, please could you be upstanding for recognition. The first set of staff of the university, 12 of you, please be upstanding. Can we give them a round of applause? Thank you. Your Excellencies, the trust of this university is built on what foundation? And the collective commitment of all stakeholders. We draw tremendous strength from the dependable, reliable Board of Regents. We have acquired enormous wit. I must say that the audacity and the sagacity of our Senate has been very supportive, and the staff of this university are wonderful. Please give yourself a round of applause. What then will I now say of the students? You are absolutely fulfilling, and may God bless you. I've never seen a set of dedicated and devoted students who know why they are here and have a sense of purpose. I have never seen a set of students who are so determined to rule the world. It is my prayer that the Almighty God will perfect His vision in your life. Yeah. The past administrators and leaders of thoughts of this university, some of them are here. You provided the foundation for which we are building upon. You have always provided immeasurable encouragement to the management of this university. We thank you for your presence, and may God continue to bless you. As I conclude, let me just use this opportunity, a very priceless one at that, to welcome all our excellencies, all distinguished guests, to this significant day, which remains in the annals of the Bledo University. I thank you for coming, and God bless Bledo University. Thank you.
The chairman of the Governing Council of the University. Please permit me, at the request of the protocol to His Excellency the Governor of Edo State, to reintroduce the representative of the Governor appropriately. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to introduce Right Honorable Comrade Philip Schweiger, Deputy Governor of the State, representing the Executive Governor of Edo State. And distinguished ladies and gentlemen, you permit me to introduce the jewel of inestimable value to our Chancellor, Lady Cherry Igbinedion. Please, thank you very much. I'm also pleased to recognize the Honorable Chief Judge of Edo State, my Lord Justice Francis Ibonuni, ably represented by Honorable Justice A.T. Momodu. Please put your hands together for him, please. Thank you.
Well, of course, we earlier announced that he's a consortium of masters
by protocol, but permit me to underline specifically for recognition His Excellency the former Head of State General Absalom Abubakar. Let me also underline for recognition the Deputy Governor of
Edo State. But of course, our Honorable Guest Speaker, my brother, Emeritus Professor Munzali Jibril. Let me make it as the first order, our Honorable Chancellor. My colleagues and member of Governing Council, management and staff of Benidia University, our very, very humble students. Mine has the remarks, and when we say remarks, we have a lot of things to underline. But because time is not strictly our friend, it has refused to go beyond 24 hours. Yet our orders get taller than 24. But let me distinguish for a moment that this is a moment of joy in so many respects. As I welcome you and I endorse the renditions are done by Mr. Vice Chancellor wholesale. But let me add one more word. You are all welcome. That God has stirred our lives to this moment is a matter of joy. That He has provided the opportunity for us to add value to mankind, indeed in the area of education. In an occasion like this, one normally picks for recognition the worry about the education cost. If you think education, as you may say, it costs you, then we might try ignorance. The difference certainly will be very clear. The honor done us to be here in large numbers, to appreciate an accomplishment as heavily elaborated by Mr. Vice Chancellor. We have seen an experience that illustrates one of the points made by Abu Bohan several years ago when he was trying to paraphrase what was happening in the West African sub-region, particularly the empires. He says one thing, nothing succeeds like success. Nothing succeeds like success. So it's a moment of joy. It's the cumulative years of successes that allow us to celebrate the 20th anniversary of this particular university. So thanks to God for that opportunity. I'm humbled because an endeavor in this area, in the simplest way, does at least 100% multiply effect. If you take each year the production of students, what we deliver to the society, and you look at the multiply effect, the result is a gargantuan effect in terms of educational development in Nigeria. I am humbled to be among the pro-chancellors that have piloted the affairs of this university. Together with the members of the Governing Council, we are happy to be associated with the university. We have learned and still learning to make university governance better. But one needs to sound some kind of warning as we evolve. The first is in terms of educational development, in terms of policies. The policies are galloping towards what I call coordinated confusion. The reason, of course, the governance has been challenged by two positions of policy, two opposing poles, one pole of quality and the other pole of quantity. If we dance towards the quality, then you must reduce the availability of university education. And that would really lead to undesirable consequences. But also if you dance towards the idea of quantity, then you say you increase upon the accessibility to the university. But again, it is also not without cost. So it is indeed kind of thing that they need to lead engineering, the kind of policy that should govern the growth of universities in our country. This may not be a moment for one to elaborate on this seminar, but what is important, that is a gyration, that is the difference in terms of funding models of universities. In particular in Nigeria, we have one particular model that recognizes support, for example in ETF, more to the public sector universities and none to the private sector universities. There is a need for us to re-examine. That of course may necessitate a re-examination of appropriate acts of governance. We have seen prices and policies that are crisscrossing. Mine will just lead the discussion in this particular era. But our case here is worthy of celebration. It is true, here, seeing is believing, not the arrangement that turns nowadays to make seeing as deceiving. I say seeing is believing, because we've seen the reality, the quantum project development, the quantum in terms of student availability, the quantum in terms of quality of students. For this to continue, we need to really examine the finances of the universities. I promote the idea of crowd financing that will now recognize for once that education is public good. And one should be watchful when you take policies that directly discriminate for any other reason. I will not open up, but I will open up time come appropriately. I have in mind here, we in the private universities, we have absence of us, but that is an advantage. But that no means should be a basis of discriminating in terms of the funding of the private sector industry. I think this is all to be re-examined. The time has passed. We are more in the area, we get more psychic satisfaction rather than financial satisfaction in terms of financing education. Many would have thought that in an avalanche of surpluses, an avalanche of profits, to be ambushed by the proprietor. Time has changed. The financing structure is no more trending in that particular manner. So there is a need for us to overhaul the idea of what it takes in terms of education and allocation. I would say that we will have an opportunity where the particular issues in relation to this area can be raised. But I'm saying time is changing and we need to hasten first in order to avoid the evolving ball of coordinated confusion. I thank you very much for listening to me and you are welcome.
Well, our father has a knack for picking the best from all spheres, all sectors. The gentleman whose voice you just heard, who is the pro-chancellor at this wonderful university, Professor Sheikh Abdullah, used to be the federal minister.
Your Excellency, the governor of Edo State, Governor Godwin Obaseki, ably represented by the deputy governor, Right Honorable Comrade Philip Shoaib. Your Excellency, the Deputy Governor-elect of Oyo State, Chairman of the Governing Council, very eminent personalities here present, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. Today, I stand in the giant shoes of our dear father, the founder, the initiator of Igbinedion University, Sir Gabriel Osawaru Igbinedion, the Eastern University. I'll read the speech, because as you know, a lot of speeches have been made and there are still more to come. So let me go directly following the voice of the great man. Today is a uniquely nostalgic day for me. Our celebration presents a pleasant platform for me to remember key industry players that sowed the seed of faith and believed in my vision 20 years ago to open the vista for qualitative private tertiary institution in Nigeria. It is very true that God Almighty raises men of destiny at critical moments of history. Nigeria had a distinguished personality of vision and peace as leader in 1999, who not only midwifed our enduring democracy, but also expanded the frontiers of university education of our children. Igbinedion University Okada is my brainchild and vision. But His Excellency General Abdulsalami Abubakar, GCFRO, who is our chairman today, gave us a trailblazing position as the premier university in Nigeria. As a military head of state and commander-in-chief of the Federal Republic of Nigeria in 1999, he believed in our dream and with great conviction approved our request for a private university. Today, we are the most sought after in the milieu of 70 private universities in Nigeria. We doff our hearts to a great man of courage and faith in a better Nigeria, General Abdulsalami Abubakar, GCFR. Today, my heart is filled with emotions. I recall the rough terrain which I traversed to establish the first private university in Nigeria. My vision and drive drove me out of my desire to bequeath to future generations university education of international standard, where the academic calendar is faithfully run without interruption and in accordance with international standards. Another eminent personality who shared in this vision is our guest speaker for today, Professor Muzadi Jibril. He was the professional educator who was the executive secretary of the National University Commission, NUC, in 1999. His place in the history of this university is unique, as he personally handed the certificate number 001 issued to me. Igbinedion University Okada has been lucky with strategic assistance. We want to put on record the invaluable contributions of eminent personality who is with us today as a special guest for her pivotal roles during and after the establishment of the university. Our Amazon is Dr. Mrs. Nike Akonde, CON. She was Honorable Minister of the Federal Republic of Nigeria under His Excellency General Abubakar in 1999 when the university was approved. And today, she is the University Consultant on Endowment. I want to place on record the efforts and commitment of the past and present chairman of the governing councils of the university for their selfless service. In this regard, I salute with profound gratitude Professor Bashir Ahmad Ikara of Blessed Memory, Professor Olu Aino OFR, Professor David Awambo, Emeritus Professor Oluwole Akonde OON, and of course the present chairman, Professor Sheikh Abdullah OON. I am very grateful to Professor Chief Emmanuel Mogwon, FAS, who served as interim vice chancellor from May to October 1999, and laid a solid academic and administrative structure for the university. I also appreciate the two former vice chancellors, late Professor Anthony Osage and Professor Ewosa Osaga, as well as the acting vice chancellor, Professor Nduka Urai, who piloted the affairs of the university at different times, for their dedication and contribution to the impressive success recorded by the university. In the same vein, I wish to thank the incumbent management, Senate, staff, as well as students, past and present, of the university for their various contributions to position the Ghanaian University Okada as the first and the best. I cannot fail to commend our dear parents and guardians who believed in us in the past 20 years by entrusting their children and wards to us to nurture them for the future. They are worthy partners in the university project. Your Excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, this celebration is for all of us. At 20 years, the Ghanaian University of Okada is just at its prime and setting the milestones for the future. Thank you very much for listening, and may God bless all of you.
I want to put a line here. Because nobody knows where the rain beat in, doesn't know where the sun died. If our capable, there are Ibrahim Babangida, did not approve it, they are not approved. I want everybody to rise. I say, Namode, Babangida.
I'm sorry, I didn't know.
Thank you.
is me. Everyone here who have good hair or good thing to say thank you. Sir, I cannot leave that for you. My life, I'm beyond what I told my children to have. Now, let me tell you a short story. He tell the phone when it was 3 weeks in the office. I was sleeping, I didn't even remember my body. Baba, if you don't want me, I'll never be done. I've got 3 weeks, I'll be here, I'll see you. I went straight. Now, after what is it that I'm here for some time, I make sure this was it, I will do it. I will feel the problem in your life. Everybody knows I have this impact.
My duty here is to say to the Vice Chancellor, who is our brother, as this has indicated, and to the good people across Niger, I said they won't. They won't. Because I'm making the Vice Chancellor one night, okay. Jideki-ji. When you say Jideki-ji, it means you are doing the right thing. Chukwu Noyele. Chukwu Noyele University, Ibiridon University. Oma Awo, Chukwu Noyele Uno. Ekenamu Uno. Nigeria Kachano.
I'm going to see something very special now. The Vice Chancellor spoke about the Bocella. Let's see it in pictures now. Are we ready for that?
In English Arabic, second class honors of our division from ABU Zaria. And a graduate certificate in education from the same university in 1974. He obtained the MA in English from the famous University of Leeds in the UK and rounded it up with a PhD in linguistics from the University of Lancaster, UK in 1982. Emeritus Professor Muhammad Munzali Tibril's career history is no less illustrious. He started out as a grade two teacher and then transferred his service to Bayero University, Kano, as a graduate assistant. Armed with the requisite academic credentials, he rose speedily through the ranks to become a professor of English in October 1989. Thereafter, he became the academic provost at the Nigerian Defense Academy, Kaduna. This position conferred on him the powers of the Vice Chancellor of a conventional university. From July 1996 to July 2001, he was Executive Secretary of the National Universities Commission. By this appointment, he became the de facto manager of the Nigerian University System, its regulator and main funding agent. From February 2002 to September 2002, he was in Lancaster University, UK, as visiting professor of linguistics on sabbatical leave. He returned to Bayero University as professor of English, from where he retired in 2015, and he was also served as coordinator of Nigeria Police Academy, Wodeo, to reposition the academy as a degree-awarding institution by September 2013. Apart from his teaching commitments in the UK, he was at various times head of department, dean of the Faculty of Arts and Islamic Studies, and deputy vice chancellor. He also supervised 23 undergraduate dissertations, 16 Master of Arts, and 4 PhD theses in the areas of language and linguistics. He was an external examiner to several other universities, including ABU Zaria, University of Jos, University of Abuja, and Usmanu Danfodio University in Sokoto. Emeritus Professor Muhammad Munzali Jibril has attended over 100 local and international conferences, workshops, and seminars, and has to his credit 48 publications, made up books, journal articles, and research reports on subjects ranging from language, literature, language teaching, through education, to politics and economics. His community service engagements are so many that I can only randomly select a few using my discretionary powers just to illustrate. He served as the first on the first visitation panel to Igbinedion University of Accra early in 2009. He is chairman, Committee of Pro-Chancellors of Nigerian Universities, currently Pro-Chancellor and Chairman of Council Katsina State University, and Vice President and later President, Nigerian Academy of Letters, August 2010 to August 2014. He is an officer of the Federal Republic, fellow of the prestigious Nigerian Academy of Letters, and fellow of the Linguistics Association of Nigeria, among other numerous honors and distinctions. Gentle, humble, and with a very cosmopolitan disposition, Professor Mozale Jibril, buoyancy of humor, laced with the right use of language, and high taste and a sartorial elegance have so endeared him to so many people that he has established a network of friends across the length and breadth of Nigeria. Professor Muhammad Mozale Jibril is a man of letters that carries a visage that is unmistakably confident and solidly academic. Mr. Chairman, sir, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, it is with honor and privilege and a great sense of responsibility that I request Emeritus Professor Muhammad Mozale Jibril, MA English PhD Linguistics Graduate Certificate in Education, Certificate of Attendance, Global Leaders Program, Harvard Business School, to deliver his lecture.
The chairman of the occasion and former head of state, General Abdusalami Abubakar, the deputy governor of Edo State, Comrade Philip Shaibu, the deputy governor elect of Oyo State, the chancellor of the university, Sir Gabriel Ibenidion, the deputy chancellor, His Excellency Chief Lucky Ibenidion, the Pro-Chancellor of the University, Professor Sheikh Ahmed Abdullah, the Vice-Chancellor of the University, the members of the Governing Council, members of the Senate, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, it is appropriate for me to begin my address by congratulating the first registered private university in Nigeria, Ibenidion University, Okada, and its proprietor and founder, Sir Dr. Gabriel Ibenidion, the Esama of Benin Kingdom, on the occasion of this important, on the achievement or attainment of this important milestone of 20 years of existence. I remember how tirelessly Sir Gabriel worked to see to the actualization of the university. Decree number 9 of 1993 was promulgated in 1993 to allow private universities to be registered in Nigeria after meeting criteria, requirements, and guidelines. Sir Gabriel was one of those who were the first to apply for the registration of this university. By the time I joined the National Universities Commission as Executive Secretary in 1996, his application had reached an advanced stage of processing. Unfortunately, in the course of managing the ASU strike of that year, the issue of private universities was mentioned, and the then head of state gave a verbal directive to suspend action on the processing of the applications because he felt that the Nigerian private sector was not responsible enough to be entrusted with the delicate task of opening and managing universities. Consequently, we had to comply by freezing all the applications, the processing of all the applications for the establishment of private universities. Sir Gabriel was aware of this directive and may have tried to get it withdrawn without success. However, when a new head of state took over in June 1998, Sir Gabriel went to work on him to plead that the applications for the establishment of private universities be brought out of the deep freezer. General Abubakar was favorably disposed to the idea, and so we were given another verbal directive to resume the processing of the applications. Within some months, we were able to recommend the first three applications for approval, namely Igbenedion University, Okada, Madonna University, Okija, and Babcock University, Elishan Remo. Igbenedion University stood head and shoulders above the rest, hence its designation as the first among equals. So you can see Sir Gabriel not only worked for his university, but opened the door for all private universities. This is an important piece of history. I remember that in his efforts to ensure the success of his application, Sir Gabriel sent one of his aides to me, to my official residence, to say that he wanted to visit me. I told the man that Sir Gabriel was my father, and that in my culture, sons visit fathers, but fathers do not visit sons. They summon them.
Sir Gabriel, the son of the man, who 20 years ago pursued the idea of a private university at the time when many Nigerians thought such an idea is a danger. The seed planted in 1999 has grown into a big local tree. A lot of us commend his vision and commitment to development of public university education in Nigeria. I also wish to commend the authorities of Igbenedion University for the choice of the topic for this occasion. The topic is well thought of and in testimony to the originality and depth of management of the Igbenedion University, as they have chosen the subject that speaks majorly challenges of federal education in Nigeria, which is funding. As a politician who just contested an election, I interacted with a electorate and became familiar and convinced that education is a top priority in the lives of many people. Endowment is a major strategy to confront the challenges of funding higher education in India that has not been fully explored in our plan. Endowment for the avoidance of any misgiving referred to allocation of assets invested by a college or university to support the education vision in perpetuity. Although the concept originated from England in 15th century, the development and practice as a major means of financing higher education is decidedly an American contribution to global development. Endowment has supported the development of universities and colleges in the U.S. for the past 300 years. Before the regime of SAP, Structural Adjustment Program in Nigeria, in the mid-1990s, government in Nigeria has given the impression that funding tertiary education was primarily exclusive responsibility of the government. The economic downturn of 1990 changed all that, and ever since we have not been able to find an enduring formula to fund our universities.
In spite of many strategies adopted to date, the nation still falls short of the facilities to admit and train over 1.2 million applicants. That is education. Yeah. Only 20% of this population is guaranteed admission. A certain percentage of a population is admitted into private tertiary institutions like Ibinedo University. We cannot talk freely like Baba Chief Ibinedo enough for setting the fault on this part when many people think it will lead to nowhere. May I at this juncture advise the federal government that they should consider inclusion of private university psychologists in allocating funds from TED Fund. As a matter of fact, the private universities and colleges are contributing to the TED Fund. Alternatively, the government should consider extending concessionary single-digit loan to private investors in the form of anchor grants, just as it has been done to the agri sector. The government offers itself to a strategy worth of more consideration than we have done, because it provides a pool of resources that are potentially inaccessible for the funding of education. The universities and colleges in developed societies have reaped the benefit of endowment for centuries. Indeed, there is a correlation between endowment fund and the quality of education in higher times. Placement of universities on the table or the best universities are rated as per endowment fund available. Harvard University, for example, with an endowment fund of $37 billion sits on top of other universities. It is noteworthy that it has been established that the wealthier the university is, the better the quality it will produce. Also, wealthier universities tend to attract world-class faculty. Usually, they have more scholarship funds, they have more grants, and they can even give concessionary school fees. The endowment part is the one to explore if we truly want higher education in Nigeria to attain a world class. In this regard, I want to commend the authority of Ibinedo University for seeking to put the issue in the national consciousness. As the incoming governor of Oyo State, our approach is to advance the interest of every business of Oyo State wherever they are found. I'm happy to acknowledge the fact that Oyo State as well is represented in the Ibinedo University. We shall partner with Ibinedo University in every possible means, both as a government and as a leader, to advance the interests of our indigenous in the Ibinedo University. Let me conclude by thanking the wonderful audience for giving me your attention. As we celebrate the 20th anniversary of this Citadel of Learning, I pray that Chancellor shall live long to see the university attain greater heights. May the university cooperate to achieve the vision of the visionary Chancellor. I thank you all and God bless.
The SMASA, a plaque for the Deputy Governor to give to the
that could have been better done. Put your hands together for Esama. Esama is the man of the world.
Thank you.
Now, just before you sit down, sir, I mean, ask of this house to come to the rostrum now, right Honorable Philip Shoaibu, the Deputy Governor of Edo State, representing
the former Governor of Edo State, Mr. Chief Lucky Igbenedion, the representative of the Governor of Edo State, the Governor-elect of Edo State, Deputy Governor-elect of Oyo State, my own former colleague Nassau Rep, and present colleague again, Deputy Governor of Oyo State, and alumni of this university. The Chief Judge of Oyo State, ably represented. The commissioners here present, the vision bearer, and the man that conceived the idea that there should be private university in Nigeria, our own leader, our own father, the man that everything he touches turns to gold, our own Esama of Benin. Members of the government, Pro-Chancellor University of the Canadian University, members of the governing board, Chief of Army Staff, ably represented by the Brigade Commander, and other service chiefs that are here, the Vice Chancellors, both the Canadian University and other Vice Chancellors and head of institutions that are here, religious and traditional rulers that are here, most distinguished invited guests, gentlemen of the press, I will also single out our female lawyers, Fida, I see the attack, and those that without them, there won't be a Nigerian university or any university, my own comrades, the student of the Benin University, greatest IOU students. They are not here. Greatest IOU students. Greatest of the greatest of the greatest of the greatest. Solely, solely, solely. Situations like this, occasions like this, we sing another challenge, yo, another challenge, yo, another challenge, yo, double, double challenge, yo. I have an address that my boss, the executive governor of Edo State, my big brother, has asked me to read on his behalf. He would have been there if not for the Progressive Governors Forum seminar that is going on presently at the presidential villa. So he has asked his younger brother to come and represent him. So I'm going to read his speech. If I read it well, clap for him. If I don't read it well, shame is mine. As we gather here today to celebrate the 20th anniversary of the Federal Private University in Nigeria, the Igbenedion University, we are not only reminded of the multiplier effect
of the dreams, but of the effect when they are product of those who know how to make dreams become not only reality, but to become a global phenomenon. I believe that the success story of Ibadan University is quite instructive. It unfolds the possibility of us as a people to drive our nation quest with the same internal passion and focus which have made Ibadan University to become a flagship of excellence. We all know and admire the personality behind the establishment of this educational movement, the Esama of the Benin Kingdom. The Honorable Chancellor and Chairman Board of Regents, His Excellency Chief Sir Dr. Gabriel Osaoru Ibiringo, a man who commands a standing ovation among global icons, a man whose humble beginning could not depend on his mind-boggling sense of self-expression and solitary accomplishment. A man who, in spite of his daring fur into unfamiliar grounds, has been able to sustain his enterprising passion with courage, not for success and profound entrepreneurial acumen in several fields. Every day, we are intrigued and inspired about the lesson of life, the love for humanity, the power of dreams, and the rudiment of sustaining and actualizing the zeal of accomplishment when we talk about this highly successful industrialist, a family man, a trailblazer, a great leader, a community builder, a very respected and influential icon, a soulful philanthropist, a man whose personality and character is credited with numerous regal honor and title, a nationalist, and an employer of monuments repute. I'm talking about Chief Dr. Gabriel Osaoru Ibiringo. As the current governor of Edo State, Governor Obaseki, I am not only impassioned by the belief that education is the key to unlock our desired greatness in the state. I am particularly happy that the Ibadan University is located here in Edo State. Having the Ibadan University in Edo State means more to the educational value chain of our state. It means provision of employment opportunity. It means economic expansion. It means additional platform for deepening of our national integration among people from different ethnic groups and cultural background. It also means peaceful coexistence, understanding and tolerance. It means a good state being a safe home for all. And of course, it also means especially rural development in this part of Edo State, Okada. Today, Ibadan University represents a stunning example of social need being accomplished and sustained through the brickmanship of private sector-driven initiatives. An enterprising entity of the nature of Ibadan University do not only deserve partnership and support from government, but it deserves accolades from all various ethnic groups, nationalists, and humanity in general. I am very proud of this solid position, which is the institution that has attained a legacy that cannot be unraveled. Our nation is no doubt continually being enriched by the crops of students which this institution has been periodically chunked out to add value to our land and people. And indeed, we are highly encouraged to find them making
acclaimed contribution in his battle of all endeavor. I listened to the Vice Chancellor when he visited Government House yesterday. We are proud to have all the students all the graduates from this school making way in all manner of fields. Oh my God. This has come to tell us that Igbenedion University, beyond the vision that it was established, there's an additional vision and mission that he has to accomplish. Being the number one, the first university, private university in Nigeria, definitely he must add to his vision and mission the best sitter of private institution in Nigeria. Because of this landmark, I must also not fail to commend the students of Igbenedion University for being worthy ambassadors of the school. Without you, the school will not be a success. So I want to thank you for being yourself and for contributing your own part to make this institution a great institution. My praise also goes out to our proprietor, staff and management of this institution for driving its mission into the realm of global government success. I will not also stop without acknowledging and thanking our former president for assenting to sign that Igbenedion University established another private university. And I listened to our daddy when he told us the history of how he struggled to get Igbenedion started. It was not started under the administration of our able chairman today. It started long ago, but it took the passion of General Abdusalam Abubakar to understand that there was need for private sector to enter into the field of university education. And that is what we are celebrating today. Beyond support for education, this is a man that was a military general, but today some of us look forward to him and look to be our role model in democratic values. He told us he was going to stay for a period, and he kept to his words. And that word that he kept to has united Nigeria more, and today we have freedom to say whatever we say that do not offend each other. So, sir, I want to thank you for what you did 20 years ago. Without that signature, we'll be gathering here today to celebrate that signature that you have appended to that document. So thank you very much. We are very proud of you. And on behalf of the Minister General, we thank you because Igbenedion University is not only adding value, but it's also bringing the state to recognition in terms of research, in terms of manpower development, and in terms of capital development. So I want to thank you for this, sir. So once again, I'm very proud to associate and celebrate with you in this hospital education in Igbenedion University. And on behalf of Mr. Governor, again, I want to thank you for listening. May God bless this university, God bless Edo State, and God bless Nigeria. Thank you. You know, our daddy is a man of letters, and he has eye for details, and he's very, very organized. So some of us are learning how to be very, very, very organized. I want to especially recognize those that came with me, the Commissioner for Education, the Commissioner for Art and Culture, the Commissioner for Physical Planning and Urban Development, the Commissioner for Agri, the Chairman of Obia Northeast Local Government. Thank you.
I'd like to present this to you for one of the important problems of the
Lady Cherry Millennium, I was there to give the program support.
Please thank you, Mr. Senator. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. God bless. Now, the former head of state.
Your Excellency, very distinguished chairman of today's occasion, very worthy chancellor, all our distinguished guests, on behalf of the great university, Benedio University Okada, we welcome you to this special, innovative, creative, and integrative part of today's proceedings. And that is that this is unique. But we must recognize that it's coming within the context of how it has been in the past 20 years in the history of this great university. And that is that he that wears the shoes knows where it actually pinches. And the fact is that to fund education, especially higher education, is not a child's play. It demands for both human and capital in terms of investment. That is why we must all once again applaud the courage, the determination, the conscientiousness of our founder, the Chancellor of this university, for having that courage to have delved into parts that others were scared to. Please, let's once again applaud and recognize our Chancellor and great founder, financier of this great university. What is it that these great panelists have been assembled to address? The representative of His Excellency Designate, that is the governor of Oyo State, has already stated it, that to fund universities is not easy. And this is more challenging for private universities, which, as we have already been told by Emeritus Professor, that it is just about 5% of those that want to subscribe to higher education, especially university education, that are entering our universities at the private level. This has commensurate implications in terms of the funds that are available to run universities. So this great panel of great minds, both national, international, have been brought together to address an international problem. It is that in the dying years of the last century, the world was becoming globalized and billionized. And what we mean by that is that the problems of Okada are also the problems of New York City. The world has become a global village. Therefore, if we must address this problem of funding for our universities, of which their one strong component is endowment, then of course, we must go beyond the boundaries of our country to see how greater endowment can be gotten for our universities in Nigeria, especially the private ones. And so, it is my pleasure, ladies and gentlemen, our very distinguished guests.
As we're hitting towards the crescendo of this event, I don't know if you've seen her, but I'd like to formally introduce her to you, ladies and gentlemen. Africa's most powerful actress, Omotola Adeleke Okeke. A lot of applause for
to be honoring my papa, Chief Igbenedion, and his wonderful, beautiful wife. I've heard about Igbenedion University all my life, and it's a university that has been consistent. The standard has been very high. I have a few friends that went to this school. I want to say congratulations today. And I like something one of the panelists said. He said the school should remember to follow up on their students and not wait till when they become president to start to celebrate them. I think that's a very, very good suggestion. I know a very good amount or number of students from this school. They have kept their honor and they have been very, very honorable. I would love to see them be celebrated and, you know, inducted and brought back to the school to support and to role model other students. As a young person myself, I want to say to all the students of this school, you are lucky. Congratulations and thank you for having me.
currently being presented by His Deputy, my host. Your Excellency, the Chancellor and founder of this university, and your dear wife, the Lord Chancellor and Chairman of the Council, the Vice Chancellor, staff and students of the universities, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me a great pleasure to welcome all of you to the 20th anniversary celebration of this great institution, the Gwinedio University of Ghana. I am particularly grateful to Almighty God that what we started in 1999, like the grain of a mustard seed, has blossomed into an oak, occupying and proudly holding its place in the education environment of the country and beyond within these last 20 years. On a personal note, and in reminiscence, I wish to recall the epoch-making event in 1999, when my humble self as the head of state of the Federation gave approval for the establishment.
Please, 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 1 minute, stop serving. Please, God bless you. Thank you, sir.
Your Excellencies, on a personal note, and in reminiscence, I wish to recall the epoch-making event in 1999 when my humble self as the head of state of the Federation gave approval for the establishment of the private university in the country after prolonged deliberations on the desirability or otherwise of private universities in the country. In particular, let me commend Isama for doggedly for 9 years following the establishment of the university. Your Excellencies, this historic approval provided a unique platform and opened the space for private intervention in provision of tertiary education in Nigeria, and resulted in the presentation of certificate number 01 to CUSA, Dr. Gebra Osawero Igwejia, CFR, the Honorable Chancellor and founder of this great university, on 10th of May 1999. Permit me to publicly acknowledge and commend the doggedness and determination of the Isama, the founder of this university. To conclude, let me commend the Governing Council and management of the university for steering the affairs of the institution in the right direction over the years, culminating in the impressive successes so far made. I urge you not to rest on your oars, as only the best is good enough for Gwinedio University, having attained this lofty height. I will not conclude my address without appealing to all of us to ensure we maintain peace in this country. Because if there is no peace, there wouldn't be any university. So it is absolutely necessary for us to make sure we maintain peace. I'm happy here. I'm one of the founding fathers of our peace committee. Senator Obi is here, and I commend his efforts and all those who join us to make sure that peace reigns. So may peace reign in our country. Amen. God bless Nigeria. God bless all of us. Thank you for listening.
Because he knows we'll wind it down. Your hands together for General Salami Aruka, GCFR, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. That is the architect, the man who could use as an instrument to make all of this happen. Now, 20 years have just flown by. Can you believe it?
What a great day for me to present a certificate to the former head of state. We'll have to make sure my grandfather are here today. great Tate Ibadan certificate. Forever and ever, we will remain committed to the government of
the world. Amen.
Everyone here, I cannot mention